There is a perpetual lie that is told to the public. Everything is fine. Do not panic. We got your back. But how many times have the public been misled on health issues, environmental disasters, or even the revolving door? Let's face it, they are not going to tell us the truth at face value ever. We have to piece it all together. And when we do, things start to look real ugly. You came here for the truth, so let me unveil that for you. If you want to know the truth, you have to dig. It's never going to come to you. It's never going to be easy. Well, today I'm going to show you some information that will be very interesting to those who are paying attention. We see the jobs numbers coming out all the time and they are fantastic. I covered this just recently. I came in contact with this article that really outlines exactly what's going on, and I thought it would be interesting to make a follow-up video on this issue. First, I want to talk about what exactly employment and unemployment are. There's a big difference here, showing you that if the unemployment rate is at 3.7%, what does that mean for the jobs numbers that are posted all the time? Does that mean we will hit 0% on the unemployment rate? Is that possible? We're going ever closer towards it. There is some information that people need to understand. Let's begin with the unemployment rate itself. The BLS provides the data for unemployment. If you look at this chart here, I know the font is very small, but it gives you an idea of the breakdown of the different unemployment rates that they have. Most people don't even know that this exists. If you tune into the news, you will see that they give you the unemployment rate. What they're referring to is the U3. Right now, that is sitting at 3.7%. Next month, it could be a different story, but as of right now, it is 3.7%. If you look at the U6 rate, that is 7.2%. We are talking about people who are marginally attached. Essentially, they are not fully employed individuals. They want to be, but they simply cannot get that job that they want. Here you can see the chart form just showing you the U6 rate and how very different it is from the U3. This has come down considerably since the financial crisis. This was sitting at approximately 17% at its peak right around 2010. And ever since, it has been coming down along with the U3 rate. However, it's about double the percentage. Here we can compare all of them side by side on this chart. And you can move your mouse over if you're interested in this at all. I will have the link in the description for you to check out. And simply you can go through here and just see over the different dates where all of these different unemployment rates were sitting at that particular time. This article fully outlines what's happening with jobs growth. It's out of Bloomberg, and I am very happy to present you this info because it actually gets into the real deal. Jobs growth has been slowing much more than most probably realize. Despite the better than forecast jobs report for June, the fact is that the labor force has contracted by more than 600,000 workers this year. And we're not just talking about the disappointing non-farm payroll jobs numbers for April and May. You heard it here. This is a contraction that is taking place, yet the unemployment rate is sitting at 3.7%. This is what people are looking at. This is what people are focusing on, and they are not seeing the contraction of the labor force. In addition, they talk about the fact that we get information from different sources. Depending on how you look at all of these totaling of jobs numbers, employment numbers, and so on, it will give you a different picture. Certainly, that's caused year-over-year payroll growth based on the Labor Department's Establishment Survey, a broad survey of businesses and government agencies, to decline to a 13-month low. But year-over-year jobs growth, as measured by the separate household survey, based on the Labor Department's survey of actual households that is used to calculate the unemployment rate, is only a hair's breadth from a 5.5-year low. So if we're looking at government statistics simply provided by a different section, we get totally different viewpoints of what's happening with employment. Growth in the Economic Cycle Research Institute's more comprehensive U.S. Coincident Employment Index, that's a mouthful, which includes both those figures and more, has fallen to its worst reading since late 2013. Because it subsumes data from both surveys, its verdict about overall job growth is more reliable than the others. I really like to see any institution out there recalculating or tabulating all of the data that is available and trying to come up with a different picture. It's really interesting to me to see this type of data, and it's available to the public. Okay, so here's some interesting stuff I'm going to get to before I finish off this video. Separately, according to the household survey, the number of people unemployed has dropped by more than 400,000 or 6.5% since December. But the number of employed has also declined by almost 200,000. So their sum total, the labor force, has fallen by almost 600,000 or about 0.33%. So if we approach the data differently, we get a completely different look at it. Okay, so check this part out right here. Since the unemployment rate is the ratio of the number of unemployed to the labor force, the numerator has seen a bigger proportionate drop than the denominator. This is why the jobless rate has fallen from 3.9% to a half century low of 3.6%. While that makes a great headline, it isn't good news. Remember that, it isn't good news. Said another way, employment as measured by the household survey has actually declined this year by almost 200,000. While twice as many who were earlier unemployed have apparently given up looking for jobs. That's what you need to understand. They will not show up in the U3 unemployment statistics. When you see those jobs numbers every month, they're pushing that out there. They are not factoring in all of the details, and this information needs to be known by everybody. I really like this last paragraph here because they start to talk about this so-called tight labor market, and they've got something interesting to tell you. The notion of the tight labor market drawing people into the labor force from the sidelines is largely a myth. Digging under the headlines reveals that job growth looks to have been substantially slower last year than the headline payroll jobs data indicate. Meanwhile, the decline in the jobless rate to a half century low obscures the unflattering truth that almost 500,000 people have left the labor force just this year. These facts are in sharp contrast to strong job growth narrative. It is so refreshing to see this kind of information being put out there. It is very difficult to find in general. You're not going to get it as front page news, but here it is. If you've made it this far into the video, thank you very much for staying here. You know what's going on, or at least you're trying to learn about it. You might not agree, you might not think exactly the same as I do, and that's good, that's great. You shouldn't think the same as me. You should be interested in digging into the information yourself. What I try to do here at The Money GPS is simply aggregate data. I find it, I present it to you, you do what you want with it. I get contacted from people all over the world, whether that's stock traders, whether that is portfolio managers, people in the financial industry. They watch my stuff, not because they want to necessarily believe what I say and do what I'm doing here. I don't get into that type of information. If you notice, I simply collect the data and I bring it to you. Because without this ability to condense information down, it's just going to float out there and not make its way into the hands of enough people. So this is the service that I'm trying to provide, and I hope that you do appreciate that. I want to thank you all for going into this type of video. You know, I know it's not the most interesting stuff for so many people. You could be watching the Kardashians. You could be interested in so much of all that garbage that's going on out there, but you are here watching this. So thank you very much for that. If you found this video informative, please hit that like button. If you didn't find it informative, hit that thumbs down button. Make your voice heard. If you want the financial education you were not taught in school, these two books have everything you need, from the foundation, the history, the asset classes. I talk about the unemployment rate, talk about the job situation in these books and what's happening and where we can expect the future to go as the central banks around the world decimate everybody's wealth. if you want the audiobook version that's available at themoneygps.com. This is the video I did recently about the job situation. You definitely want to watch it. It coincides with this info. Click on it and I will see you there.